Hey guys, Streamlit introduced a new chat feature which is pretty cool. In this video I'm going to show you how it works. We will start simple and then we will build a ChatGPT clone in under 50 lines of code. Like on the OpenAI website, you can input your prompt and you will get a response. Now, for full disclosure, the code we are going to write comes straight from the Streamlit documentation. You will find there a written step-by-step guide. But I thought it might be helpful to create this video for you. Okay, with that said, let us dive in. First, we need to make sure that we are using the latest version of Streamlit. You can do that by typing pip install streamlit --upgrade in your command prompt or terminal. Once that's done, we will start a very simple example. After importing Streamlit as STE, I'm using the new element called chatMessage. I'm going to use the user role and I will display hello. Now I will save the script, go back to my terminal and run the app. Once my page is up, I will move it next to my text editor. And there we have our simple app. The chat message feature is like a container. Inside this container you can put other things like the write element. Chat message has two parameters you can change. The first one is the role, which can be user or assistant. If you change it to assistant and rerun the app, you will see that the picture changes to a bot icon. But you can use a different picture by using the avatar parameter. Here you can use an emoji or an image. I will use an emoji and when I reload the page, you can see that the picture has changed. Alright, let's kick it up a notch. I will first write the entire application and then I will explain what each part does. In this example, the bot works like an echo. If I type hello, the bot responds with hello. If I keep typing, you will notice that the chat keeps a record of our conversation. This is possible because we are using the session state feature. This feature allows your app to remember data between user interactions, much like a web browser's memory during a browsing session. To use this feature, we first need to set it up. I'm going to call my session variable messages. If it doesn't exist, like when I reload the browser, I will set it to an empty list. Later, we will add dictionaries to this list. The dictionary will look like this. The role, which will be either user or assistant, and content, which will be our input, so our prompt, or the corresponding response. Next, before getting user input, I will display the chat history. So, I will go through the messages list I created earlier. For each dictionary in that list, I want to show in the chat message container the role and the actual content. These two lines are like the first simple example I showed you earlier. Now, when you first run the app, the list will be empty. To get the user input, Streamlit has another feature called Chat Input. This is the input box you can see at the bottom of our app. I use the Walrus operator to assign the user's input to the prompt variable and check if it's not none in one line. But you can also do it like this if you prefer. First, store the chat input in a variable and then check if the prompt is not none in the next line. If you reload the page, the app still works. Next, we are just displaying our input in a chat message container. Once we have displayed the message, we add it to our session variable. As I mentioned earlier, we are adding a dictionary. The first key is the role, which is user in this case, and the second key will be our content, which is our prompt. Okay, now we are going to do the same thing for the response. I'm using an fstring here and that includes our input prompt. And then, just like before, we are showing the message in the chat container and saving the response in our session variable. But this time, we will use the assistant role. Alright, if you understood this, you can now create more complex chat apps like a ChatGPT clone. So, instead of returning the same prompt as the answer, we want to ask ChatGPT. To do this, we will use the OpenAI library. To install it, go back to your terminal or command prompt and run pip install OpenAI. With that done, I can now import OpenAI. Next, I will change the title to ChatGPT-like clone and load the OpenAI API key. If you don't have one, you can create one on the OpenAI website. Just log in, go to View API Keys, and make a new secret key. Instead of putting your API key directly into your app, I've used the Streamlit Secrets Manager. In a bit, I will show you how to set it up. But first, let us also pick the model we want to use. For this, I will set up another session state variable and set it to the GPT 3.5 Turbo model. Now, back to Streamlit Secrets. To use it, make a new folder named .streamlit in the root directory of your app. In this folder, make a new file named secrets.toml. In this file, you can put your API key and give it a name. Of course, I will revoke my key, which you can see here, before I upload the video. But once you've made the secrets file, you can load the value as I did here. Alright, for the final part, we just need to tweak our response. As before, let me write the entire code first, and then I will explain it. As we did earlier, I've started a chat message container for the assistant. But this time, we are using an empty placeholder. We will update this placeholder later. Next, I'm setting full response to an empty string that we will use to slowly build the ChatGPT response. In the for loop, we are calling the OpenAI API. We pass our model, which is saved in the session state, and the conversation history so far. Also noticed, here we are setting the stream parameter to 2. This lets us slowly get the ChatGPT response and simulate a typing effect to make our app more interactive. In each iteration of the loop, we add a piece of the ChatGPT response to our full response string. Next, we use message placeholder to show the response in the chat window so far. I have included a vertical bar character at the end to simulate a blinking cursor and make it look like the assistant is still typing. After the loop, I will display the full response one more time using the message placeholder, but without the blinking cursor this time. Finally, we add the ChatGPT response to our messages list in the session state. This ensures that the response is saved and will be part of our conversation history for future interactions. And that's it. When I save the script and rerun our app, you will see I get an error. This is because I messed up the indentation a little. I'm missing a space before the context manager. So after fixing this, we have our ChatGPT clone. Now let's test it out by asking for a joke. As you can see, we still have our chat history and the bot remembers our previous conversation. And I think this is pretty cool. With less than 50 lines of code, you've made your own ChatGPT clone. Now, as I said, I took all the code directly from the Streamlit documentation. I will also put the link to this page in the description box below. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.